Brushing your teeth might seem like a mundane act of hygiene, but what if I told you it plays a direct role in your vascular system, including blood flow to the penis? Sounds far-fetched? Science has a clear answer. The elegant part, it's simple. The surprising part, it's true. Let's look at what your oral hygiene might reveal, not just about your teeth, but your blood vessels, including the ones that matter the most when it counts. Today, I'm crossing into a new territory, from urology to periodontology, because it turns out what happens in your mouth doesn't stay in your mouth. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, board-certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. Let's dive right into the oral cavity. The oral cavity, a fascinating place in direct contact with the outer world, a port of entrance for all kinds of bacterial and viral threats. The oral cavity is like a market in one of those Star Wars movies. No joke, it's a dense crowd, and some of the residents aren't exactly peaceful. Question: what is more dangerous, being bitten by a dog or by a person? You already guessed the answer, just by how I asked. Believe it or not, human bites are far more severe. They tend to trigger aggressive infections and heal poorly. But things are not always as peaceful as they seem. These microorganisms seem to live in peace in your mouth, but they will turn against you if you let them. Normally, your body's own defense mechanisms will contain them, but sometimes they will find a way to get into your bloodstream. Most of the time, your immune system handles them with ease. But you know how it goes in Star Wars. The dark side has an endless supply of TIE fighters. This is exactly what's happening here. The body fights back, but the bad guys keep coming. Some of those attackers release toxins that silently disrupt your inner balance. It's inevitable they will cause some damage. If we translate damage into a more precise term, it would be inflammation. Inflammation is a reaction of the body, a healthy reaction because it serves a purpose to reestablish tissue integrity. However, chronic inflammation is a problem. A chronically inflamed body will not work properly. It stops releasing enough nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is a vital gas that's produced by the inner lining of blood vessels and nerve endings. Without it, erections will not happen. But could you counteract that with supplements? Citrulline, pycnogenol, and so on. That's an exciting question. And if you're enjoying this video so far, why not give me some digital applause for it? Subscribe, share, and give it a like as a sign of your appreciation for my work. Thank you. I will tell you about supplements later, but before we go there, let's talk about something even more powerful, something you can start tonight, what you can do to defend yourself from these germs. It is so simple, it's almost ridiculous. Brushing your teeth at least twice a day doesn't just keep your teeth healthy, it also supports your gums. And even more so if you floss or use interdental brushes before bed. General health starts in your mouth. It's like a construction site, always under pressure, with tooth decay, gum inflammation, and tartar just waiting to strike. Honestly, who hasn't experienced it? But the real threat has a different name, periodontitis. This is when aging, tartar, and bacteria sabotage the supporting structures of your teeth. In periodontitis, your gums become a leaking barrier, a silent entry point into your bloodstream. Science gives us some really alarming numbers. It's a true public disease. After 35, every other person is affected. Beyond age 65, it is estimated that more than 90% suffer from more or less severe periodontitis. What does more or less severe mean? It means the affected start to lose their teeth. You know what's interesting? When we compare these numbers to erectile dysfunction, severe periodontitis correlates surprisingly well with erectile dysfunction. Well, it's a correlation. That's a tricky statistical term. It means two phenomena occur together, not necessarily one causing the other, but here, all evidence points to exactly that. Chronic low-grade inflammation of the body results from periodontitis, and it compromises erections by inhibiting nitric oxide. Science knows other disruptors of NO production. All causes of chronic inflammation can cause that, and mostly a concerto of several of these mechanisms come together. Other common causes include excess body fat within the abdomen. That's highly active fat causing a lot of inflammation. High blood pressure, diabetes, sleep apnea, and many more also contribute. So it's not the oral cavity alone, but the oral cavity may be the most underrated and overlooked in this scenario, because doctors are not dentists. That's an important communication barrier that must be broken for better healthcare. I have several go-to sentences when I don't have a clue what's going on with my patient. One of them is, could it be the teeth? Sometimes it is. Before this video ends, I promised you a quick look into supplements. Maybe you have watched my recent video about the best supplements for the penis. If not, I will link it at the end. Most of these supplements work by boosting nitric oxide. They deliver the raw material that gets converted into NO. If the body is chronically inflamed, NO production is compromised. So if the factory is closed, nothing is produced. It means that supplements can help you under one condition, that you are as little inflamed as possible. Brushing your teeth is a good start. Flossing and interdental brushing is even better. And additional professional dental cleaning once or even twice a year will do the trick. I will address other ways of fighting chronic inflammation in the future. If you are interested in supplements, here's the video I announced. But before you watch it, you may want to go brush your teeth.